behind the madness that is this series. Pastrana off the line on the outside. Going to try and shut the door. Fraser McConnell side by side with him. Pastrana going to have the inside line at the end of the straight. McConnell's going to merge in just behind him. But we've just seen a great race. McConnell goes deep around the outside. Can't do that in turn two. Now we look to the inside line. This would be a great one if he can stay with Travis.
I bet you Fraz takes that Yokohama Tire Joker lap. If I was him, that's what I would do. Does he do it? No, he does not.
He came with you. Control the corner.
So we're hearing, we can hear in our ears here, control the corner. We're hearing Travis's spotter live.
Awesome.
So he's saying control the corner. He's with you. Listen up.
Scrub the jump.
Scrub the jump, he's just been told. So they're telling Travis exactly what they want him to do. Watch for Fraser McConnell now. Fraser is outside. He's getting a lot in his ears.
Half car length,
Travis has just been told. This is brilliant. I've never heard the spotters live like this. It's absolutely fascinating. Travis getting quite a lot of information.
Control the corner.
Control the corner.
So stop talking, Cole. I want to listen. I'm joking.
Yeah.
That's what we're paid to do.
It's mad, isn't it?
It is great.
Oh, man.
Just as we lay
he's
out.
Going Joker. Okay, hit this lap now.
So he's telling
hit this lap.
He says, get this.
Yeah, hit this lap. This lap has to be perfect because this is the overlap. This is when, Fraser has gone, Travis hasn't. So he's got to make sure now that he absolutely nails this lap. Then you can respond immediately, Jared, and cover him off. Or, if it's gone really well, you might wait another lap. The gap 6.6, we know 6 is just about enough.
Right there on that cusp.
I got 6.2.
Is your spotter chatting you up as much as or less important?
Yeah, it's about the same, obviously. Yeah, my spotter's Corey,
and he's
talking the same amount. And we have obviously different lingo, but it's definitely the same information.
Yeah. You've got to be clean.
You've got to be clean. I'm loving this.
Well, basically what he's saying is don't overcook the car. Don't overdrive the car, right?
Stay left and drive that corner wide.
Well, even tell him to take it wide.
So you're clear, clear, clear. Control the corner. Control the corner.
So you can take it wide, is what he said, and then when they realize they've got the merge, he says control the corner. So really interesting terms that they're using in the car. I'm sure Travis replied at one point in the previous lap, Jared.
One car length.
Same one car length, so he's telling him where he's at on his heels. Don't check your mirrors. Race your own race. But Fraz is right there, 1.2 seconds behind him.
Interesting to me that he said one car length there. What Cabot, he's not letting him go. You know, if he told him 6 car lengths, he might chill out a bit too much.
That's definitely a strategy right there, is make sure you feel the pressure and you're not going to make a mistake by letting off.
So, because that was clearly more than one car length.
Oh, yeah, that's plenty right there.
Hit your mark now.
It's a great perspective.
Hit your marks.
And he is. And Travis is driving really, really well right now. He is precise. He is performing surgery at this Glen Helen track. Again, round 4. I'm Jared Deanda, Andrew Coley, Cabot Bingham, Jonas.
He's pushing hard here.
This is one car length, like, once again.
He's just covering that inside line. You see, he did what we said there on the last one. He let him, he sucked it right into the apex and gave no room. He says, now push, get the checker. The flag is out. It was brilliant to hear that spotting and great tactics from them. And a shout out to McConnell as well, Jared, because he was right there.
The signature thumbs up.
Nicely done, bud.
Travis usually, so remember, if you can recall.
Thanks for the gaps, I appreciate that. That was very helpful. He's really quick. I wanted to take the joke on cylinders, I took it then.
What did he say?
Yep. So right call, but guess what, you're quicker. Nice job.
Okay, so he said he's really quick. I wanted to take the joke, so I think he didn't want to give Fraser any longer in terms of lap time. But then he spotted saying, you're quicker, which is, that's him picking him up a bit again. It's so good. And Fraz will love that. The fact Travis has said that, he'll love it.
Right? Oh, absolutely. I mean, this is a dream come true for Fraz.
Yeah.
This young kid, he grew up watching him, right? So obviously, he needs positive affirmation. You don't break him down like, you're driving terrible. Some people need that. Like, come on, Cabot, you're driving terribly.
I don't know. I think you want positive affirmation.
Oh, you definitely do. Rallycross is so intense, so having that positive reinforcement actually helps, especially when you miss a corner by like an eighth of an inch and you're like, I just blew it. We need that.
Me and Jared both think Travis has taken a step this year in terms of his Rallycross. Obviously, we know he's won titles before in rally, but he just is a better Rallycross driver, isn't he, this year?
Oh, yeah. He's picked it up in terms of skill and performance substantially.
Yeah.